Guys, if you like 4x4 vehicles as much as we do, I think this video will be interesting for you. Today you will see extremely rare, experimental 4x4 amphibious USSR cars. Incredible cars, but they had never been produced on the line due to the global crisis of the early 19th. Stay tuned, we are to start right now. Let's start with this strange-looking vehicle, which is called WAZ Jaguar. First of all, this machine stands out because of the very peculiar look. I think many of us painted such cars in our childhood, didn't you? But such a design resulted from the fact that this vehicle is a real amphibian. It was designed in 1976, and 14 experimental units had been produced by 1990s. Under the hood we see here a regular 4-cylinder petrol engine, nothing interesting. But there are other interesting solutions. There are two screw propellers next to the rear axle, you may see them now, and the front wheels are used like a rudder on water. As a result, on water this car can accelerate up to 10 km per hour, that is not bad for an amphibian. Besides, there are other features. The mechanical winch driven by the engine, waterproof body, extraction pump and so on. The vehicle managed to pass numerous severe tests. It was used in the toughest conditions, it went through the heat and snow, mountains and swamps. It proved to be a very effective all-terrain vehicle, but unfortunately it had never been produced on the line due to the collapse of the state. So few people in the world know what this model is. This is experimental USSR project, which is called Neva River. Looking at the car, it's really hard to believe that this vehicle is also amphibious. The base here is the legendary USSR 4x4 vehicle Neva. It's extremely popular off-roader throughout the world, and the engineers managed even to improve the car by making it amphibious. I think if this vehicle had ever been serial produced, it would have been a real off-roading masterpiece. Unlike the previous car, the construction of the vehicle is not very complicated and expensive. In fact, it's almost the same legendary Neva, with insane off-roading capabilities, but this one is amphibious. The body, gearbox and transfer case are waterproof, and also there is a special damper that makes an engine waterproof too. But there are no any screw propellers, so it can move on water only by rotating the wheels, so the speed is not very impressive, about 4 km per hour. The interior is mostly standard, it's functional and well considered. By the way, it is a convertible car, the soft roof can be removed in warm weather. The project passed through the numerous tests, the results were so successful. It even was approved by the government for serial production. But again the same story, it remained in history only as a project due to the collapse of the state. And again, we have here the victim of hard times of the USSR history. It's so-called LUAZ, 1901. For civilians, it was presented at the exhibition in Kyiv in 1998. But initially it was constructed for military purposes in early 70s. This project was a last chance for the manufacturer to avoid the bankruptcy. Unfortunately, it was too late. But the project itself is gorgeous. The all 6 wheels drive, the independent suspension for each wheel. The tests prove that the vehicle is extremely effective on rough terrain, besides it's rather smooth for the passengers due to the advanced suspension. Moreover, the wheelbase is rather long, so the car is able to climb the ascent of 58 degrees, so impressive result. There is a diesel 3-cylinder engine, 1.5 liters capacity and 51 horsepower, that provides the maximum speed 60 km per hour. It's not astonishing speed, but on the other hand it's also a real amphibious vehicle. It moves on water by rotating 6 wheels, with the speed 5 km per hour. The interior wasn't completely designed, but we can see here inside the car huge space for many passengers or equipment. Totally it was produced only 8 units, and nowadays this unit is possibly the last one. And this one is the most ambitious USSR project in car industry. The engineers were going to make one of the most popular 4x4 vehicle not only in the country, but in the whole world. And I should say that the vehicle has all the features to become an extremely successful off-roader. Meet the WAZ Wagon! Why is it interesting? The point is that the engineers tried to apply the best solutions of all the huge experience of USSR military car industry. Durable solid frame. The body made of the high quality steel, decent design for their times. There even was the possibility to choose the engine. There were two variants, gas engine 2.9 liters capacity and 105 HP or diesel one, hydraulic power steering, quite moderate fuel consumption about 11 liters per 100 km, decent speed 120 km per hour. Inside the car we can see nice and functional interior and a lot of room. But the most important in other features. Its off-roading capabilities. There were numerous tests on rough terrain, and absolutely all of them turned to be very successful. Such bright capabilities resulted from the Porto axles. That is why the ground clearance is huge, it's 330 mm, and the wheel track is 1460 mm. Besides, even the standard model has a snorkel, so it can move in water with depths 1.5 meter. After successful passing of all the tests, this project was approved for serial production by all the official channels. But again the same story, and totally it was produced only 9 units. Well guys, all these machines were going to be serial produced but for the state crisis, and I am so interested to know, how successful would have they been? Maybe now all our 4x4 vehicles would be on amphibious machines as a standard option. Please post in the comments your thoughts, if amphibious off-roaders are worth to be serial produced. And one more question. Please give us your opinions if you want to see on this channel more videos about various rarest machines like these ones. Thanks for watching guys, please consider subscribing the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, it will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.